Hey guys, welcome back to Life of Monday, and today we are going to be doing a year-end review. We are year-round homeschoolers, and so we are actually almost done with a lot of our curriculums, and some of them we're just halfway through or even just beginning because of the way that we flow with our curriculum in our year. So I thought I'd take a quick second and share with you guys what's been working, what hasn't, what we ditched, what we stuck with, what we changed up for this year, in hopes that it helps you in figuring out what you might do for next year. So let's get started. Hi, my name is Katie, and welcome to Life of the Mundane. I am a second generation homeschool mom of six beautiful kiddos, and on this channel, we talk all things resources. I love to share with you resources that are going to help you in your homeschooling and help encourage you in your biblical parenting, and how you can utilize those to their fullest potential so that you can make the most of the little moment. I do want to note before we jump into these curriculums that this is not everything that we did this year. We did geography, we did additional unit studies outside of this curriculum. The kids had individual work that they did, but I'm just covering the basics of our group subjects and our language arts and math and Bible, things like that. So I just wanted to give that caveat up front, but I still hope it can be helpful to you guys. First up, let's talk math. So we'll start with my youngest one for math. For my second grader this year, she started out the year doing Math Lessons for Living Education, book two. She's done book one, she went on to book two, she did great with it, she finished through, all of her older siblings have done Math Lessons for Living Education through book two, and then they moved on to teaching textbooks. So that was the plan, to do the same with her. However, at the end of book two, we just felt like she really didn't retain enough of it. And part of it is that she has a genetic disorder. And so it makes it really hard for her to retain information, especially math in particular. And she really needs it explained a lot of different ways. It didn't ultimately end up working super well for her just because it didn't have enough review and it didn't teach concepts in multiple methods. It just used sort of one way to teach. For my older kids, that was perfect and fine, but for her, she needed more. So we finished out the book probably in February, March, and then we moved on to Horizons. We actually went back a level and went to a Horizons 1 because this is a more intensive program, but also because there just were a lot of gaps that we wanted to fill in for her. They do a great job of teaching this curriculum and teaching different concepts in multiple different ways, so that was something that was really appealing to me. Plus, it's just incredibly colorful and eye-catching, and she's a very visual learner. So we've jumped into this. We're just into book one, and I will actually be having a review of this, or a flip through, I should say, because we haven't finished the book. We'll have a flip through of this and kind of explaining why we like this program and why we chose it, coming out here on Saturday. So be sure to subscribe and click the little bell notification so you'll be notified when that comes out. For my older kids, we did teaching textbooks. Fourth grader, we did teaching textbooks four. And for our two fifth graders, we did teaching textbooks five, and they have loved it. We've actually been doing the 4.0 version this year, which has been amazing. I am really excited to be sharing with you guys more about what's so special about the 4.0 version here in May. We also used extra math as an extracurricular as a way to strengthen their math fact skills. And we used that for the three older ones. We did not use it for my fourth just because she's not ready for those time drills yet. We need to get down the basics before we really try to master those concepts. Plus, that's something that ultimately she'll probably long-term end up struggling with. So we're fine just kind of taking it a little bit at a time. Next up, let's look at what we did for language arts. We used a whole plethora of different things. Some things we stayed with, some things we didn't. If you guys have been following my channel for a while, you know why some of those changes came about, but let's just start diving into some of them. So for one of my fifth graders, we were finishing up All About Reading level four. We have finished this and we've completed it. I love this program. It is such a solid program that really doesn't leave a whole lot of gaps. And it worked great for him. He really was a struggling reader. We've taken 5 years to get through four levels, but ultimately he has finished it. He is reading well and really enjoying reading on his own. And now that he's finished it, we're just doing assigned readings with some simple comprehension questions to help him in those skills. And he doesn't need any further reading instruction. We also used level three of All About Reading with my fourth grader this year. And we did ultimately end up stopping that about halfway through. And that was because we started tutoring. Like I said, if you've been on my channel for a while, you know what I'm talking about when I said we started tutoring. We found out that my oldest and my third, so my oldest son and my oldest daughter, both have dyslexia. And so we found an amazing tutor to be able to come in and help with the kids, teaching them in a way that really made sense for them. So we just shelved All About Reading three for her to take tutoring instead. And ultimately it was the best decision. It's not because All About Reading was not a good program, but having something that was so personalized and tailored to her specific learning needs was just too valuable to pass up. Same with our next choices, which was Happy Cheetah Reading. So if you guys knew, I had two kids in Happy Cheetah Reading. We really love this program. I still love this program. I think I'm still planning on having my little ones go through it as they get older. But ultimately, again, tutoring came along and we had the opportunity to trade this in for specialized dyslexia tutoring each and every week, multiple days a week. So we ultimately ended up ending that curriculum for now, but it may be something we use again as a supplemental thing or that we go back to for sure for my two littlest ones. Next up is spelling. For most of my kids, we have been using All About Spelling. That's what we started out the school year with. Again, however, part of the tutoring that they receive is that it covers their reading, their writing, their spelling, their grammar, their handwriting, all the different things. So all of that was shelved for them, but we did continue doing All About Reading for my oldest, for my second oldest son, who is in fifth grade. And so he has finished level 2 and is into level 3. He will have that finished by the end of the year so that next year he can jump into IEW Phonetic Zoo. I love the way that All About Spelling really complements All About Reading. I've had a lot of people, a lot of you guys have asked, can they replace one another? Like, can they learn the reading from the spelling skills or vice versa? And the truth is they really are two totally different skill sets. Even though they seem like there's a lot of overlap, there's a lot of the concepts that are similar, it really is taught differently and it is received in their brains differently. So I really recommend kind of using these programs side by side or using them to supplement other things you're doing and not so much to think that one of them can do both things because that's asking a lot of one program. For grammar, for my second son, we use Fix It Grammar, the Nose Tree. He is still in this book. He is getting ready to, he'll finish it here in the next few months. He is loving it and it has been so amazing. For those who don't know about IEW's Fix It Grammar, it is a grammar program that allows you to learn grammar concepts by editing and marking up other people's work. So instead of just learning rules and trying to figure out like cool little worksheets to fill them out and hope that that retains and is used later on, it has the opportunity for you to take one sentence a week or one sentence a day, excuse me, and take it and identify the different parts of speech or different parts of the sentence. You're going to add in the punctuation. You're going to do some small tweaking and editing. You're going to copy that. It even has vocabulary involved. It has been great for him. However, that was a little too heady for my ones who are still struggling with reading and for those who had dyslexia. So before we had the tutoring, we were using Grammar Galaxy. We have been using this. We've used it on and off for several years now and really enjoy it. My kids actually love the audio version of the teacher's textbooks because it teaches grammar through stories and that they're just super engaging to my kids. So even though we have shelved the curriculum for now, just because, again, they don't need it as an extra thing right now with the tutoring, we have been listening to the stories anyways because why not? There's so much that can be gained from these stories, even if you don't do all the worksheets or the additional activities. For writing, we tried to do IEW's People and Places in Our Community. Now, this unit for IEW, if you're familiar with the Institute in Excellence for Writing, is a lot different than the ones they have for the older kids. This is designed for like first or second grade, but I decided to do it because the concepts that are being taught in here are very, very similar to what is taught in their later programs, but the source text that you are writing from, that you are using as a main resource in your writing, is much easier when it comes to reading. And ultimately, I had a lot of struggling readers, obviously, again, with the dyslexia that we didn't know about. So I decided to go back and do these much more simple texts so that they could focus more on the writing than on the reading. But ultimately, we ended up shelving it for the ones who ended up doing tutoring. And for my son who did not do tutoring, we stuck with it. However, he was the one that is definitely capable of handling the older work. So he was getting kind of bored or frustrated with it just because it wasn't level appropriate for him. And so because of that, we are moving into structure and style either over the summer or over the fall. We haven't decided which. And for right now, we're just focusing on really cementing his spelling and his grammar so that he will be ready to go into structure and style in the fall. Now, when it comes to our group subjects and what we've used, we have, for science, we've been using Apologia's Astronomy, the Young Explorer series, and the kids have loved it. I've done an entire video on this, kind of what's involved, and some of our favorite fun science experiments from that. If you guys want to check that out, I'll link it up in the bio or down in the description below. For history, we've done Story of the World, Book 3, and this one covers about the first to the 49ers. And so this is a huge span of history. And I'll be honest, when we first started this book, even though we've used the other two books and loved them, I felt like it was a little bit slow starting for me personally. There was just a lot of wars and conquering and battles going on in all different places. I love the fact that it is world history, so you are looking at what's going on in all different geographical locations at one time. It was a little confusing and hard for my kids to follow, but after just the first maybe 10 or 15 chapters or so, and there are a lot of chapters in here, they really started getting into it. They really started loving it. We're very invested in it and excited to finish this book up so that we can get into level 4. But honestly, I thought it was going to be my least favorite book, but it's really quickly coming around to being one of my favorites so far. For Bible, we used several resources, but I'm going to just talk about two of the primary ones we used, and that is the Investigating God's Word. This is the second time we have used these Investigating God's Word at Home series. And then last year, we took one book of the Bible. We took the book of Acts, and we read through it in its entirety over the whole school year. This year, we're doing the same curriculum, but we did Romans through Jude. So we are almost done. We'll probably finish this up here in the next month or so. And so I'm really excited about that. It has been amazing. It has scripture. You read the scripture, it gives you questions to ask your kids, and it gives you the answers, which I love. The last thing we've been using for a Bible that I'm going to talk about in this video is our character studies. So if you guys have been following my channel for a while, you know we love to use these New Growth Press books. These are just a few of them. God Made Me Unique, talking about special needs. We have one on Gus Loses His Grip, talking about when you want something too much, stealing, and other issues like that. Zoe's Hiding Place, when we are anxious. All of these great books. I have actually made free guides that you can use alongside these with your kids to talk about these different character traits. So you'll read through these books. You will get the opportunity to get some other books from the library or check out YouTube links of these videos. There's activities, there's Bible verses, lots and lots of fun stuff, totally free. If you guys want to check that out, you can check that out on my website. I will drop the link down below in the description, but we really have enjoyed this. Now I will say, we didn't get through one a month. I have posted one a month on my website, so you can get the entire collection up to this point, totally free. But I ran into the issue that we just kind of sometimes wanted to sit in a topic for a little bit longer. So next year, we'll probably, or even into the summer, we'll continue these studies until we finish them all. I would love to hear what has been working for you or what hasn't down in the comments. And if you guys want to see what we're using for next year, I've got a whole playlist of all the curriculum reveals for next year that you guys can check out right here. We'll talk to you guys next time. Bye.